You are all welcome in this class. Earlier we have seen convergence of improper integrals of first kind. There were two tests, comparison test, mu test, and several examples based on those tests. Now it is time to study improper integrals of second kind, means integral having infinite range of integration. And in the first kind, the range is your finite, but the function is unbounded. See, there are three types or three cases. First, case one, integrals of the type integration from a to infinity, fx dx. See here, this upper integral is infinity. So, but the function f is bounded and integrable for all x greater than or equal to a. Convergence at infinity, see this one. If f is bounded and integrable for all values of x greater than or equal to a, then the integration from a to infinity fx dx is defined by integration from a to infinity fx dx is equal to limit t tends to infinity integration from a to t fx dx. Just write here t in place of infinity and take limit t tending to infinity. Just earlier we have done this. Earlier, suppose lower limit is 0 and the function is unbounded at 0, then we take it as t and limit t tends to 0. The integral a to infinity f dx is said to be convergent if the limit, this right hand side limit, exists and is finite. And in case this limit becomes plus infinity or minus infinity, then this integral will said to be divergent. This is your first case, convergence at infinity, when infinity is your upper integral. Case two, integrals of the form minus infinity integration from minus infinity to b fx dx. So convergence at minus infinity. Here your function f is again bounded and integrable for all x less than or equal to b. Then this integration from minus infinity to b f dx, it is defined by what? Limit t tends to minus infinity integration from t to b fx dx. Now this integral will be converging or is said to be convergent if this limit of right hand side on the right hand side of 2, if this limit exists and is finite, only then we say that this integral is convergent. And in case this limit becomes plus infinity or minus infinity, then the integral will be called as divergent integral. So these are two cases for convergence of improper integral of second kind. There is one more case, third case, where both the integrals, both the limits of integration are one is minus infinity and another is plus infinity. Let us see third case also. See the third case, integrals of the form integration from minus infinity to plus infinity f dx. Convergence at both ends. It means, see here, integration from minus infinity to plus infinity f dx. It can be written as integration from minus infinity to c f dx plus integration from c to infinity f dx, where c is in between point. Now, this integral will be converging only when both these integrals are convergent. Otherwise, we do not say them to be convergent. So for the existence of this integral, these two integrals must converge. We have some examples for you. See, example one, test the convergence of the following. This type of problems you will see in your university examinations or external examinations for 80 marks. See here, solution, first one. By definition, integration from 0 to infinity e to the power minus x dx. See first, this is your improper integral of second kind, because here we have infinite integration limit. So it is equal to limit t tends to infinity integration from 0 to t e to the power minus x dx. It is equal to limit t tends to infinity. Now integration of e to the power minus x will be minus e to the power minus x 0 to t. So it is limit t tends to infinity 1 minus e to the power minus t. Why 1? Because e to the power minus 0 is 1 and minus minus times is your plus 1. So 1 minus e to the power minus t. And when t tends to infinity, this e to the power minus t becomes 0. So its value becomes 1. It means this is 1, which is finite. It means limit exists and is finite. Therefore, the integral is convergent. So first problem is solved. Next, see the second problem. Integration from minus infinity to 0 e to the power minus x dx. It can be written as limit t tends to minus infinity integration from t to 0 e to the power minus x dx, as this we have defined earlier. It is equal to limit t tends to minus infinity. Now integration of e to the power minus x is minus e to the power minus x t to 0. So this can be written as limit t tends to minus infinity minus 1 plus e to the power minus t. Why? Because if you substitute x equal to 0, this will be your 1 and minus. So it is minus 1 plus e to the power minus t. And after substituting t tends to minus infinity, this will become your infinity. The whole thing will become your infinity. So this is plus infinity. It means the given integral is not convergent. It is your divergent. See the third type of, which is mix of first and two. Integration from minus infinity to plus infinity e to the power minus x dx. It can be written as integration from minus infinity to c e to the power minus x dx plus integration from c to infinity e to the power minus x dx. Write it same as I1 plus I2. See here I1 is divergent. We have proved earlier, but I2 is convergent. And therefore, the result of both of them will be that the given integral is divergent. So this problem, question number one, is solved. Next, we move on to example two. Test the convergence of integration from minus infinity to plus infinity dx by 1 plus x square. See its solution. Integration from this minus infinity to plus infinity 1 by 1 plus x square dx can be written as integration from minus infinity to c dx by 1 plus x square plus integration from c to infinity dx by 1 plus x square. It can be written limit t tends to minus infinity integration from t to c, this is your function f dx, plus limit t tends to infinity integration from c to t f dx. Now it is equal to limit t tends to minus infinity 1 upon 1 plus x square, integration of this function will be tan inverse x. You must remember this, from t to c plus limit t tends to infinity, this is tan inverse x from c to t. So this is equal to limit t tends to minus infinity tan inverse c minus tan inverse t plus limit t tends to infinity tan inverse t minus tan inverse c. See, this is tan inverse c, this is tan inverse c minus, both will cancel each other. So it is equal to limit t tends to minus infinity minus tan inverse t plus limit t tends to infinity tan inverse t. Now this is equal to minus tan inverse minus infinity plus tan inverse infinity. So minus times tan inverse minus infinity is your minus pi by 2, and plus tan inverse infinity is your pi by 2. So this is your pi by 2 plus pi by 2 means it is pi, which is finite and limit exists. Therefore, the given integral is convergent. So this problem is also solved. The next, we have four problems in one example. We will see one or two of them, and the remaining part you will solve in your notebook. See the first one, integration from 0 to infinity sine x dx. See, we can write it as limit t tends to infinity integration from 0 to t sine x dx. And this can be written as limit t tends to infinity. Now integration of sine x is minus cos x from 0 to t. So this is equal to limit t tends to infinity minus cos t and minus minus cos 0. So it will be your plus 1. So 1 minus cos t. Why? Because cos 0 is 1. So this is limit 1 minus cos t. But since this t tending to infinity, and for this t tending to infinity, 1 minus cos t is limit of this is, this does not exist. therefore this integral does not exist. So we move on to second problem. Integration from 0 to infinity x cube e to the power minus x square dx. It can be written as limit t tends to infinity, integration from 0 to t x cube e to the power minus x square dx. Now this is your x cube, this is your x square, so we need to take x square as another function. So we write integration x cube e to the power minus x square dx as x square into x e to the power minus x square dx. Now take x square is equal to u, so it will be 2x dx will be du, means x dx is du by 2. Here we have x dx, so this integral can be written as 1 by 2 integration u for x square into e to the power minus u into x dx. For x dx we have du by 2, this 2 is here, so it is equal to 1.2 u into, integrate this one by parts, first is this one and second this one, so u into minus e to the power minus u, first function into integration of second, minus integration, differentiation of first, differentiation of u will be 1 into integration of second, minus e to the power minus u du. So it is equal to 1.2 minus u e to the power minus u plus integration e to the power minus u du. So this is 1.2 minus u e to the power minus u and minus e to the power minus u, because its integration is minus e to the power minus u. So this is minus 1 by 2 u plus 1 e to the power minus u, means minus 1 by 2. Substitute the value of u, this is x square plus 1 into e to the power minus x square. So the one part, the given integral will be limit t tends to infinity, minus 1 by 2 x square plus 1 e to the power minus x square from 0 to t. So it is limit t tends to infinity, 1 upon 2. When you substitute x equal to 0, so this is your minus 1 by 2, minus minus 1 by 2 minus plus 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, substitute x, t for x, so t square plus 1 into e to the power minus t square. So you will get 1 upon 2, because limit of this one, the second part, if you take its limit, it will become your infinity by infinity. Now we apply L'Hospital rule, and that will tend it to 0. So we will get only 1 by 2, which is a finite and limit exists, therefore the given integral converges. Similarly, you have this part, third part, and later on you will have this fourth part. So this third and fourth both are for you to practice, and if you face any difficulty, you can just send me a message on my WhatsApp group, or also this lecture will be available on YouTube. So you can see all the lecture from my YouTube channel. There is a comment section. You can comment also there. So now you just note down them. And if you have any query, you just ask me here.